A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 13 September, on the front page you have Ayodhya. Supreme Court frowns on UP minister's remarks. Court's reservation will be recorded in the order, says Chief Justice of India. So this is regarding the remark by Uttar Pradesh minister that the Ram temple would be built on the disputed land as the Supreme Court is ours. So this should not be happening in the country is what the CJI says. Both we deprecate such statements. Both sides are free to put their arguments before court without any fear. This is there. Then this is capital's power skyline set to change. So government plans new parliament, common central secretariat and new look central vista in Delhi. So Janta is planning the changing the skyline as such. And these new completely retrofitted parliament building etc. would come forth. Then this is incidents of lynching unfortunate. So this is Minister of State for Home who has said that the incidents of lynching were unfortunate and the center would speak to the Jharkhand government about the dropping of murder charges against the suspects in the lynching case of Tabrez Ansari. Then on page 9 you have, as Gujarat slashes traffic fines, center gears up for a tussle. So the state government of Gujarat has slashed down the fines under the Motor Vehicles Amendment Act of 2019, but then it has gone below the lower limit prescribed in the act. So the Ministry of Road Transport and Highway has sought the Law Ministry's opinion on whether state governments can tweak the lower limit for fines prescribed in the law. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Bolton Goes. So this is regarding US National Security Advisor John Bolton, who has been asked to quit by US President Donald Trump. So this editorial says that India must not allow its ties with the US to be dictated by the dynamics of the Trump regime. So this aspect should not change India-US relations and its relations with other nations in US context, like our relation with Iran, And you know, these are the things because of USA. There are hostilities with Iran. USA has imposed sanctions on Russia. Then the brinkmanship on trade, the trade war with China, and talks are opposed in Afghanistan with North Korean leader, and also regime change has been pushed by USA in Venezuela. So all these are US standpoints, and based on the National Security Advisor and the administration of USA. So that should not change India's ties with USA. So that is what the editorial says. And this is futile fines. So this is regarding the high road fines. And the editorial says that better enforcement and infrastructure are key to mitigating anger over higher road fines. The lead article, Congress stuck in a quagmire. So this is regarding the ideological schisms and defections and arrests which are taking place in Congress. So this is about political developments in the political party and the crisis which it is facing. And this is US-Iran detente could be on the cards. So this is regarding exit of John Bolton. So he had a hawkish stand, especially on Iran too. And Israel's influence on Washington is also diminishing. So this signals a possible reduction in tensions between USA and Iran. Then on Fridays on op-ed page, you have this parlay coverage in which you have a view counterview given on a topic, and today it is, are public universities under threat? So political interference and intolerance for critical debate have left universities without vitality. So we are seeing presently the controversy with respect to JNU too, where they have been asked, professor emeritus have been asked to submit their CVs and the review would take place. So such interferences in university functioning by politicians is a cause of concern. So view counterview is given on this. And this is a belligerent border policy. So this is how US President Donald Trump is strongly pushing back against migrants, and the US courts are yielding in regard. So US courts are allowing it. Then on page 12 you have, maths never helped Einstein discover gravity, is what Piyush Goyal, the economic affairs minister, commerce minister, has stated. So he has given this controversial statement that don't go by the GDP numbers and figures, you don't need to go by the maths. Those maths never helped Einstein discover gravity. If he had only gone by structural formulae, what was past knowledge, I don't think there would be any innovation in this world. So, this is the statement given. So, of course, this has brought in criticism. The minister later asserted that his comment had a certain context as such. But this is the kind of statement which has been given. And here you can see, earlier we have seen how even the finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman had given a statement that automobile sector is suffering because of the new generation, the millennials. New generation is not buying vehicles, they are using Ola and Uber. So that's why automobile sector is suffering. It was her statement. Then this is Modi launches pension scheme for farmers, shopkeepers. So this is regarding the ambitious scheme which was planned, Pradhan Mantri Kisan Mandhan Yojana. So this will help small and marginal farmers by providing a minimum pension of 3000 per month on attaining the age of 60. So this is applicable for farmers in the age group 18 to 40 presently. And another scheme for shopkeepers is Pradhan Mantri Laghu Vyapari Mandhan Yojana. So this is a pension scheme for shopkeepers and retail traders. So this will be there. And another Swarozgar pension scheme has also been rolled out for self-employed persons. And under both, same is applicable. Between 18 to 40 years is the eligibility criteria. And they'll get 3000 per month after completing 60 years of age. Then below you have NADGRID wants to link social media accounts to central database. So this is the ambitious National Intelligence Grid project. It wants to link the social media accounts of the huge to the huge database of records related to immigration, entry and exit, banking and telephone details, among others. So this project was started in 2009, and you know, at least 10 central agencies have access to the data on the secure platform like Intelligence Bureau, Research and Analysis Wing, etc. And now they want social media accounts to be linked. Then on page 13 you have India-China face-off in Ladakh ends. So soldiers of India and China were engaged in a face-off which escalated into a scuffle near eastern Ladakh. But now the face-off has ended. So a 12-member army patrolling was objected to by a team of Chinese soldiers that resulted in this tussle. But it was quickly resolved. And this is all 16 nations set for final RCEP deal. So this is regarding regional comprehensive economic partnership. So India, there are conflicting signals whether India will join RCEP or not. But Australia is lead negotiator for this 16 nation FTA has said all countries have committed to completing talks in time for RCEP summit on November 1. Then on international page you have water found in atmosphere of hospitable exoplanet. So water has been discovered for the first time in the atmosphere of an exoplanet with Earth-like temperatures. So it could support life as we know. So this is a planet which has been named K2-18b. It orbits in a star's habitable zone at a distance neither too far nor too close, where water can exist in liquid form. So it is 8 times the mass of the Earth. This has been reported. It says this is the planet. This planet is the best candidate we have outside our solar system, where life can exist. Then below you have U.S. top court allows Trump government's asylum restrictions. So U.S. Supreme Court has allowed President Donald Trump's administration to implement asylum restrictions that prevent most Central American migrants from applying at the U.S. border. So these curbs have been approved or allowed. And this is Trump agrees to delay increase in China tariffs. So after apparent reconciliatory move by China, where China did not increase the tariffs as per the timeline, US President has also now made one of his own efforts and announced that he agreed to delay an increase in tariffs on $250 billion worth of Chinese goods by 2 weeks. Then on business page you have IIP growth rebounds, retail inflation surges. So electricity sector growth is slow at slows to 4.75% in July from 8.19% in June, but food inflation is at a 14-month high. This is the data given. Then below you have railway waives 15% peak season surcharge. So this is the initiative taken by Indian Railways. There are slew of incentives announced, including this waiver of 15% peak season surcharge on freight transport. So it says this is to give industry a boost in wake of slowdown. And this is renewable energy expo put off to October 2020. So slowdown, subdued sentiments are reasons that the event that was slated to be held in October-November this year, Renewable Energy Expo, is being put off to October 2020. So this is Reinvest Expo, which is held by Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So that is it. These are the important headlines. There is no news coverage on the last page. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashar.com. You can download the current affairs PDF there. Thank you.